Jed Smith's encounter with a grizzly bear. Jedediah Smith struck west from Fort Kiowa late in September 1823. His little company numbered 16, most with bonds forged on the sand beach. Among them were Bill Sublette, Tom Fitzpatrick, Jim Clyman, and Thomas Eddy, with their objective, the heart of the Crow Country. 5 days into the expedition, it nearly lost its captain. Leading exhausted horses single file through a brushy bottom, the men spotted a big grizzly bear charging down a slope toward the center of the line. The beast turned and raced to the head of the column just as Smith emerged from a thicket. Instantly, the bear pounced, seizing him and throwing him to the ground, smashing several ribs and clawing his head. None of the trappers claimed medical skills, but Smith directed one or two men to go for water and said, as Clyman wrote, "If you have a needle and thread, get it out and sew up my wounds around my head." It bled copiously, for the scalp had been torn nearly off and hung only by an ear. Clyman found a needle and thread, got a pair of scissors and cut off his hair, and then began my first job of dressing wounds. He got the scalp sewed back on, but said there was nothing to be done for the ear. Smith insisted that Clyman try. He did. I put my needle stitching it through and over, laying the lacerated parts together as nice as I could with my hands. Within 2 weeks, Smith had recovered sufficiently to resume his captaincy, although he bore scars for the rest of his life. This gave us a lesson on the character of the grizzly bear, which we did not forget, observed the Bible.